This morning, once you saw on CNN, they had a picture of Les Paul. Oh, Les didn't die, did he? Les, please. In the far front, they were talking about what an active man he was at 87. And still playing. So Holly and I went over there to see last night. He's 76 and plays like he's about 25. He's amazing on the guitar. And this is a song I learned from Les and Chet.
It's amazing how you speak back.
But when I found the guitar, and it was one of those things, I broke the key on the third string, tuned it with my dad's pliers till I got so sick of it. He'd let me play his 52 gold top sometimes, but not often enough. And then I had to tune that thing. He picked me up from school. He picked me up one day. I was walking home, actually, and he said, "Son, get in the car. I got your guitar fixed up for you." I'll never forget taking me down to the store, looking around at all those guitars that day. I thought, wow, they got pretty. Back then, it was Vox. It was pear-shaped things, and the old Gretches, and the white Falcons, and the orange ones, and all that, and the Fenders, and all. It's cool stuff. I've never seen it like that. And he said, "Got your guitar fixed up, and I expect to see some little off-color white key here, Mark." You know, I didn't want to see that. But I walked over, and Dad at the music store were just standing there looking at me and grinning the whole time, walking up. I'm going, "Okay, where's my guitar?" And they opened the case, and there it was. Brand new Gibson J45 guitar. I'll never forget that as long as I live. For the first time, I saw that my parents put real value. See, unless you see value in something, you want to invest in it. See, some people think, "Well, my music's not worth anything." One old guy told me not long ago, "Well, I don't play very good. I've just got an old cheap guitar." I thought, "Well, that's why you don't play very good." That's one thing I thought about, because it really does help to have a good instrument, as good as you can afford it. May not be a Taylor, but whatever you can get. Maybe at least put it on your dream or your wish list. And it wasn't that long ago that I couldn't get a Taylor at that time. But it worked out finally. And when I did, it changed my life. It changed my style of playing. I was basically an electric guitar player. It went back to my first roots, back to my first love. So invest in your kids. My mom and dad did me, and I do my kids. And I tell you, it's a viable investment. And they love traveling. They love going. We've had the best time. And Haley, just a moment, you know what we'll do. I've talked about touchstones in life and sort of things that you won't forget, and like the sailor, the white rose, you know. But it's not all just that for me. You know, everybody thinks sometimes, "Boy, you just got a great life traveling around the world." And I do. Last year I went to Shanghai, China, and Hong Kong, and all over Japan, all over Europe, and the UK, and just all over the world. It was a wonderful thing to be able to share my gift. And along with that, sometimes comes things that just kind of unexpected come up, and hardships and toils out there that you don't see. You know, life is just, you know, they think, you know, it's just magic for me. You mentioned where are the little guys that come in and set up your stuff. And I was hauling this 85-pound imp up here. And I said, "Well, I don't have any little elves around to do it, and I wish I did." Life is that way. Somebody said, "You know, sometimes life just gets daily." You know, and it's true, and it's that way for all of us. I'm no different than you are. The girls last Sunday had a wonderful time. We played a little church not far from here, in fact, and it was not on the books. It wasn't something that they could, you know, just, it was just a last minute thing. We didn't have time to, we didn't know where it was. We had to call on our way here, find out where we're going. But we did it as a favor. And, it was wonderful. God said, "I want to pray with y'all. Pray God to protect us." That's all I did. Just God watch over. And that night we went to Redlands, and we were in a church, and it was wonderful. About 800 people there, maybe 1,000. And I was signing autographs and stuff, and the guy says, "I want to pray for you." And he just put his arm around right there in the middle of everybody. He says, "Lord, watch over Doyle and his family tonight." And that's all he said. Be with them, protect them. And we had friends in from Omaha, Nebraska, that flew in for their daughter's graduation. They knew me, so they traveled 90 miles or so over from their hotel to go hear us play. We visited with them. Paul Rivera came in, like I said. And then it was just Caleb and me and Haley and Holly back in the old red van. Traveled all the way across from, all the way through Texas. We're back in the van. "Well, where do y'all want to eat?" "Well, let's go." We found a little restaurant. We'd eaten there before. Nice place. And this is a little chain from Southern California. and we're, I heard a little commotion going on. I mean, just moments before, I was signing autographs, you're the greatest thing since sliced bread. The next thing you know, I got a shotgun on me. And a guy calling me boy. I called him sir. And four hooded men came and robbed everybody in the place. You know, life is not always what everybody expects it to be. It's not always easy. And I turned around and I saw a man on the ground. I saw what was going on. And I turned to my kids and I said, get down, guys. There's nowhere for to go. It was as close as I am to that black guitar right there. And I thought maybe he was robbing the guy who was on the ground. And I looked up and I saw the guy with the hood and the gun. And there were four of them that walked in. And I turned over to my girls and I said, let's pray. And we just hovered together and it just began to do just that. What else can you do? It's like going down on a plane. You know, I had no control. I had no control as a dad. A few moments before, I decided I wanted to turn right. I turned right. I turned to the parking lot. I said, let's see here. We decided we'll all go in. I was in control. And then suddenly, I have absolutely no control. I'm at the mercy of a man with a gun. And he stole a little money from us. No big deal. In exchange for our lives. Why are you telling me this? Because, you see, folks, sometimes it's not always what you think it is for everybody that just goes around doing this. We're here tonight. When I said at the beginning, I'm glad to be here, I really meant it. I really meant that. There's a lot of things that could happen that we won't even go into all that, but we are just so thankful. I had just said in the church that morning that we should be thankful for every day that we wake up and say thank you for another day. For a song I played tonight, Great Is Thy Faithfulness. Thank you. His blessings are new every morning. And so I didn't come here to wear my religion on my sleeve. And I came here with a guitar around my neck, but I really mean what I say. And I think sometimes doing this kind of stuff, there's probably somebody out there that doesn't like it very much. That guy could care less if I was a guitar player. He doesn't care if I'm in the Taylor Wood and Steel. He didn't care if I have a signature model out in the car with a whole bunch of money in the case he didn't know about. He didn't know about any of that. We put that in the bank today. He didn't get everything, but he got enough to have a good time with it. But I just want to say, folks, tonight is very special. I don't know that I'll share this tomorrow night. I don't know, I might, or the next night, or I may not ever again. But when I say we're glad to be here, now, folks, this is a special night. We are glad to be here. We are glad to be alive. I've played better than I played tonight. But we've been through a little bit in the last couple of days. But I really think now, probably more than ever, this song means more than it ever has. Thank you. Now, I want you to know something. I didn't tell you this tonight to make you feel sorry for us. I didn't. I said it more as a praise thing, a report, than anything, I guess if you want to call it that. But I gave my daughters a chance to fly home and go home. I said, no, Dad. We want to play. We want to sing. We want to be with you. Centers or play at your church or your synagogue or whatever, or some retirement, maybe like I said, retirement centers. I had one guy who said he went to a retirement center. This old guy didn't like him. He's an evangelical and he didn't like him. And he said, I just recorded. He's going to give him a record. He said, I just recorded my last record. He said, good. I said, well, maybe it's not my last one. He said, sir, do you know he's a star on the Grand Lopper? He's a good friend of mine, Mike Snyder. He said, sir, do you know who I am? He said, no, if you tell the lady at the front desk, she can tell you. So it may not always be a great experience. But you can go out and honestly, you can create smiles. Sometimes the girls and I will go over and we'll play next door to the little lady there. The little lady. It's not on the internet. We do things sometimes not advertised. I played for 800 retired preachers and their wives just a few nights ago. And that was a blast. That was so fun. And so I encourage you folks to use your gifts. And if you've ever seen me before, you know that's my message. And so I hope you'll do that. Create some smiles yourselves. And I'm sure you can do that. All right. Mark, thank you. Let's hear from Mark and all the guys. Taylor Guitars as well for putting this on tonight. The last we didn't get to keep. That's not even funny, but I can laugh about it now. They're going to laugh and cry. And it's, what's funny is I never keep money in my guitar case, in case you're wondering. And I almost gave it to Holly, but that was like weeks of stuff. And so here we go. But we're so thankful. Thank you again.
No, thank you. What did I promise you that it would be a treat that you would remember for the rest of your life? There you go. All right. We got a little bit of stuff to give away.
I got